A very good morning, everyone. As we get really close to the mid-evaluations, we have another workshop to give you a break from the monotonous hours of coding. Today, we have with us Ms. Pavandeep Kaur, SDE at Juspay. Pavan has been working with Juspay for over 3 years now and has been a part of the team that developed Juspay products in the initial phase. It is an honor to have you with us today, Pavan.
Thanks, Shaurya. Hi, all. I hope you all are good. So I'm going to tell you about more about Juspay in details. So like how many products we have and how Juspay is contributing in online India's payment, and how those products helped us to, to make more productivity, and how those products are helping in online payments, and which all technologies we are using, how those technologies are helping us to do the 10x work. So let's go through. Let me share my screen. I hope it's so visible. So I hope you have seen this logo while doing the online payments. So behind this logo, this complete payment is happening end to end. So it's like we have the different player who is participating in this payment. It's like detecting money from user account to sending money to the merchant account. This complete flow is behind this logo, which is working to make the complete payment end to end. So Juspay founded in 2012, and there was two product in starting. One was the Express Checkout and other was the Godel. So Godel was aiming to remove the friction in 2FA, and Express Checkout was the unifying layer on the different gateways. And we are using functional programming in Juspay, which is helping us to make more productivity. And we have like 5 million per day transactions. So let's go to the numbers. So we have the different merchants like Flipkart, Amazon, Uber, Ola, Swiggy, Dream11. These are very commonly used apps. So if we are using UPI payments on Amazon, Swiggy payment, all payments are going through Juspay itself. Like bulk of India's merchants payment traffic of mobile passes through Juspay. You can see our number. We have started from 2012 and then continuously we are growing. 2.2 billion transactions so far we have done. And 5 million transactions per day we are doing. As you can see, this is a payment, and nowadays in all app without payment, almost all app we need a payment. If you are ordering food, if you are purchasing something, if you are traveling somewhere, all the gaming apps, most of them apps has the payment. And if payment come to the picture, then Juspay also will come to the picture, because Juspay is helping to do complete the payments from end to end. So our all across merchants are in different areas, like they belongs to e-commerce, travel, hyperlocal, deco. So you can see like Make My Trip and all, these are all the big merchants of Juspay. So let's see Juspay's product. So we have the Juspay Safe 2FA, Hyper SDK, fully native page. We have payment gateway, API unified. We have the Galileo UPI. We have the 2FA using Bank Mobile app. So we will go in more details for these products. So let's start with the Juspay Safe SDK. So what is the Juspay Safe SDK? It was aiming to remove the friction in 2FA. So before, it was founded in 2012, and before 2012, when we were doing this 2FA online card payment, manually we were just switching the app and we were reading the OTP and we were entering the OTP. But in Juspay Safe SDK, what we did is automatically, no need to switch the app, it will automatically take your OTP and it will enter there, and automatically it will be filled there and your payment will be get completed. So then there will be the less friction in that. So it will be not only like reading the OTP automatically, but there will be more feature also. So you have seen this page now. This page is the like issuer bank page, and issuer bank page size itself is very heavy, and this box and all, everything was very small, So what we did is we just did the lightweight of this payment page, and we are using the caching also. So with the help of caching, if we have, suppose first time you have did the payment and next time you are doing the payments, then already that redirection page caching is there, then next time it will be very fast. And if you will see the actual payment, the actual bank page, that is this is actually JustPay safe page. Actually, this box is very, you know, big, but actual bank page has very small box. You have to just zoom it and you manually you will enter the OTP. But now it's a very clear page and automatically it will take the OTP from your message and it will enter there. So this was the JustPay safe browser. So there are many across, you know, many merchants are using this. I think this is a page you have seen everywhere, and Amazon, Uber, Ola, Make My Trip, Swiggy, Book My Show, Airtel, Zomato, all these merchants are using JustPay safe SDK. So next product, we have the Express Checkout. So what is Express Checkout actually? So when any merchant, I want to start any business, I want to sell something, of course I need a payment. I want that user will pay and pay to me, so I want to provide that online interface for them. So it's not like directly money will be get deducted from your account to it will be sent to the merchant's account. There are different things in between. So those things are like gateways, wallets, PG aggregator, different UPI PSPs are there, net banking PG. Other app and see the OTP and entering, it will automatically get detected that OTP and filled in that same text. And some more UX flow fix are there in issuing bank page, and some caching and network, those things are there in JustPay Safe SDK, which is helping to improve the issuing bank page. Express Checkout. So Express Checkout is the layer between gateways and the merchant. So if merchant wants to do the payments through different payment method types, suppose wallet, card, NB. So instead of directly integrating to those gateway, directly integrating to those wallet, they can just contact to JustPay, and JustPay will internally route all the traffic to these different payment method type. Now directly if they will go to the gateways, then they have to integrate their different APIs. That is, suppose I'm starting some business, then instead of caring about, you know, spending time on payment flow, I will focus on my business. So directly I can just go to the JustPay and I can take that layer and I can use that unified APIs to do the payments. So now we have all the directions which are going through JustPay. So we can do the smart routing also. We have the dashboard also where we can just track all the taxes code failed or success. So it will be helpful to merchant can see their success rate. Okay, these many transactions we are getting, this many are successful and this many are. And if some gateway is down, then internally we can just route to the other gateway on the basis of their success rate. There will be zero downtime. There will be not, okay, today's sneaky app is not working because the payment is not working. That thing will not be there because internally we have that smart, that routing switching is there where we will just go to a different gateway on the basis of rate. And there are more features also like offer engine, recurring payments. So we're like offer engine, like getting the listing, the offers, any transaction is happening, we can just, that you can just tell to the merchant that something is going wrong in your system, you have to take care of that. So some forms of transactions are coming. So it's like Express Checkout is overall unified, which is we give to the merchant directly integrated with those all things. And you can see when we do the online payment, there are the big layer into the picture like error or network. So all these are contacted with the and internally we are just calling internally, we are just routing the traffic there. 2016 we have developed this UPI Bheem app when UPI came to the India. So before UPI there was like only 2FA online payments was there, but then they said, okay, why can't we take one identifier, and with the help of that identifier we can just transfer money from one bank account to other bank account. So now suppose if I want to transfer money to someone, I will take all the, okay, what is your card, what is your IFC, what is your bank number. So directly I can just ask VP and I can transfer the money. So before 2016 there was no UPI concept, was not there. Now it's a very common like Google Pay and Paytm, all these I mean, all app has, but it was started, first app was a UPI Bhim, which was developed in Juspay. And there was all the features, sending money, request money, and we can issue the VPA itself. So after UPI Bhim, we have the PSP also, like we can issue the VPA. So if we have the PSP, means any merchant, we can just give the complete UPI product also to that merchant. So if you are using Amazon, Uber, Ola, Cred, Grofer, these apps, and in this app, if you are using, UPI, if you are doing your payment through UPI, then you are going through the Juspay. Because for Amazon, complete front end is the Juspay front end in UPI, where you see that, okay, if you don't have the VPA, you can create the new VPA. If you already have the VPA, then you can just do the payment in Uber, Ola, that onboarding flow and everything that is the Juspay's front end also, back end also. Both things are Juspay's one. And I think these merchants are very commonly used by everyone. So you have seen already. So these are SD, which was the part of payments. Can't be the complete payment page. So this is our native payment page. We will handle internally all stuff. This express checkout, Godel thing, and we will just give you the complete payment page. Suppose if I said I have the business and I want to do the payment, so I will just take this complete payment page. Like front end will also be the Juspay front end, and I will just integrate this payment page. And if I want, okay, I want just cards and wallet, I don't want the UPI, then it will be removed. And according to my requirement, that option will be there. And backend also, end to end backend will be handled by this payment page itself. This will be like same, it will be customized by merchant. So suppose my app color is blue, okay, so I can't take this yellow, I can't take these icons, because my app icons and complete design is different. So that is also customizable. So according to the merchants, that will be like config. They can just say, okay, these are the things I want in my app, and we will just make a same payment page and we will give them, and they will just use that same. And if any new logic is coming in, suppose new flow is coming, new update version is coming for payment page, then there is no need to update their native app in Play Store. It's not like, okay, some features are coming in payment page, then we have to update the native app. That will be not there. It will be automatically, that smart dynamic updation is there, that their payment page, it will get automatically updated with new features. No need to update the app on Play Stores and all. So we have this Ola, Big Basket, Vodafone Idea, OK Credit, G5, JioSaavn, Echo. These all the merchants, if you are using all the merchants, then when you click on the pay button, so you just hit the add to card and then you click on the pay. After pay, complete that payment and things are just the same. So these merchants are using complete just pay payment page. Then there was like Juspay 24/7 help. So we have all transaction details, right? Because we are the layer between express checkout and all these things. So why can't we just help the group? Suppose some transaction for one, and my status is a successful or failure. I can't wait. So maybe there is a lag between send or Juspay. So instead of waiting for to use, we can directly just tell to the user, okay, your transaction is a success, failure, maybe emails, notifications. So it will be like unblocking the merchant or unblocking the users for their transactions. So this is Juspay Gatekeeper next. So Juspay Gatekeeper was like we already have this 2FA where we enter the OTP and all, and when we complete the payment. So instead of OTP, why can't we just use other things? What can be the alternate of that? Suppose I'm doing the online payment. First time I did the payment via card, and the second time when I'm doing the payment via card, why should I have to enter again OTP and all? This is like only I am verifying, okay, this is my phone, then maybe something can be handled internally in phone. So that was a fingerprint. So I'm doing the payment via card. Next time when I want to do that payment, so I can just verify with fingerprint. I can say, okay, I'm the guy, my phone is this, so you can just complete the payment, and then payment will get completed without OTP. So you can see then there will be the network issue will be very less, you know, because sometimes when we do the payments, we face this issue. Network issues there, I'm not getting the OTP. If I'm not getting the OTP, then how will I will enter the OTP, right? So, but this fingerprint is completely native thing. It's a completely that device thing. So then there will be the, you know, zero network issue. So that was also purpose for just the gatekeeper. So you can see this is like complete layer on the top of complete payment system. So you can say payment method type like card and the UPI, all these stuff there. It's a one layer which is handled by JustPay. So extra checkout, Galileo UPI, JustPay Save, HyperSD, and in backend we are just you know is all the gateways, PCI, you know, merchant and these issues, and we will handle all the this native page for all the next steps how did we scale to 5 million transactions per day with all app put together? How did we build up TV? How to grow 10 million SDK with my platform that only large companies can imagine building? So it was, so functional programming is very cheap to the DSLs. So there is like alternative programming also, but we chose a functional programming because it's a fully typed. So there will be the zero, you know, production issue because you already know what of the type or which data is coming to your system and you are handling. You know everything end to end. It's a fully typed language and DSLs are very cheap. Means you can make the framework in very, you know, cheap manner very easily, and those things of course will be helpful for you know, for productivity. It will of course make easy all the development. So we are using functional programming in just the, you know, last 5 years. So these are the all the frameworks, DSLs, which we have developed on functional programming. There are more, but for now we are covering all this. So this is, there is a Hyper SDK, which is like container of micro apps. This is the same which is used in payment page. There was a native payment page. Yeah, this one. So native payment page. So here we are using the dynamic updation, which I talked, where if any new feature is coming, then it will be automatically updated. So there that framework which is used, is that is the Hyper SDK, this one. Yeah. So how working is actually flow in Hyper SDK inside payment. It's like space is completely separate, payment is separate. It's a working micro app. So it will remove one micro app, affect the other micro app. So it will be like dependent from each other, update also. If I add the UPI, I can add or remove. So those things are there, and and code is because all single code Android OS. This is also a one framework which is developed in reporting. So you can, it's a very readable actually. So code is very readable. Like you can just see, okay, what this complete flow is doing, and we have this framework developed to make it easy, like development. So there is like a reusable code. At one place, and if you want to develop any new thing, we are just calling that thing and it will be handled automatically. So the same thing is in front end also, and in back end also. In back end, you know, I mean, there are like services like Redis, DB, and these all services. So every time we know this Redis VK, everything will be required for every backend product. So why can't we just unify it at one place and we can call that and we can use it? So for that, we have developed Presto backend for that. In traffic, and you can do the stagger release. You just, okay, I want to just deploy the 5%. We will see how new features come in, how that is making difference. Then we will deploy other code so that auto deployment is there, A/B testing is there, and with the help of logging, we can just detect, okay, this thing is going to happen. We can maybe fix before that itself. So this was to make it the production easy. So at place we can see for all the traffic via merchants and gateways. So this framework was this Electra framework is for so we thought why always developer need to take care of their all the development. So there can be some tool where operational team can just use that tool and automatically code will be created with that tool. So actually in our Jaspe, like always bunch of APIs every day we have to integrate because different gateways are there, different aggregators are there, and why can't we have the tools where non-tech person can also do the developments, like maybe they can just we just want to make it easy for everyone, not only developer will do but non-tech person can also just see and they can just use the tool and they can just do the they can just do the coding. Payment page configurator was also to we also want to do the automated payment page. So if we want to develop the payment page, we can just give the config. With the help of config, automatically payment page will be get created. And for different platform also, like OS, Android, desktop app, mobile web. So you have to just give the config, and with the help of that config, a complete payment page will be created. And you can give the different color itself for that payment page. Like you can see, Jaspe is the India leading mobile payment platform for merchants. So our target is to become the AWS payment on the, for complete payment. So our target is like to grow to the 50 million transactions per day. Yeah, you can ask any question if you have.
Thank you so much, Pavan. And if any of the attendees have any questions, they can drop them in the questions box. One question was there just as the workshop started. It says, what does Jaspe do exactly? So if you could just elaborate on how Jaspe works, that would be really helpful.
Yeah. So what Jaspe do is it's a in between. So when you do the payments, okay, so we can't do the payments without gateway. So if you want to do the card payment, so gateway is the essential thing which we need to use. So it's a layer between gateways, acquirer, issuer. So instead of, okay, if I have the business, instead of going to everyone and integrate their APIs, I can just go to the Jaspe and I can same thing which I explained just now. And Godel automatically reading the OTPs. So these are the different part of the end-to-end complete payment.
Okay. So if there are any other questions, you can drop them in the chat box. Yeah, hello. Am I audible? Hello. Are both of us audible to you guys? Hello? Yeah, so we are audible. That's not an issue. And if there are any other questions, you can drop them in the chat box and we'll end the session. Hi, Pavan, am I audible to you? I think Pavan is facing some technical issues. Anyway, thank you so much everyone for staying connected with us, and we'll meet again tomorrow, today evening, and we'll resume with the other talks and workshops that have been lined up for you guys. Thank you so much. Bye bye.